On touchscreen devices, panning and pinching gestures are handled exclusively by the browser. But you can change this if you're using Touch Action CSS property. The Touch Action property tells the browser how to handle panning and zooming gestures. It accepts a number of different keywords, and the most important that I will cover right here are auto, none, and manipulation. By default, the value is auto, and this means that browser will handle all panning and zooming gestures. The second value is none, and this tells the browser not to handle any of the panning or zooming gestures. And the last value that I want to show you is manipulation. And this enables panning and zooming gestures, but disables all other non-standard gestures, such as double tap to zoom. And disabling double tap to zoom actually allows the browser to eliminate the delay between user action and the event in the browser, because it no longer has to wait to be certain if double tap to zoom happened. You can just handle the event exactly as you want. Use this in your web apps if you want to make your interface a little bit more responsive.